Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, we will try to answer a question I frequently get from viewers and readers. Do I need Excel VBA or Python for supply chain analytics? To answer, I will change my journey in data analytics, starting from my first internships to the different projects I conducted as supply chain engineer. In most of the articles I publish in my blog, I'm using Python to solve an operational issue. But for some of them, I can design the solution with Visual Basic. In this video, we will explore the difference and understand why we would need both. My journey in data analytics started with Excel VBA during my first internships. I developed great tools for several companies, but spotted the limitation quickly. Limitation that pushed me to learn Python and start using it in my daily job for projects related to logistics and supply chain. However, nothing is perfect, and Python also has its limits. Therefore, we will see why you may need to master both. I started to use VBA during my first internship in the R&D center of a nuclear plant in France. My mission was to design an Excel tool that calculates the dimension of anchors to fix hydraulic pumps used in nuclear reactors. The task was to write the mechanical equations and transcript them in Excel formulas. What happened? After a week, I finished the calculation for a specific type of pump, and I thought my task was accomplished. But my manager asked me to generalize it to 100 types of pumps. I thought it was impossible for me to spend weeks creating hundreds of Excel files for each type of pump. I needed a solution. My problem was simple. I know how to build a spreadsheet for a single type of pump. I must find a method to generalize this sheet to any type. My manager gave me a book, Learning VBA from Scratch, and told me, "You have 1 week. Good luck." It is a great way to learn by doing, especially with a very intuitive language like VBA. First, you have the recording book. It will be your best ally to learn the syntax and functions. If you want to automate a specific task, launch the recording tool, perform the task manually, and the tool will write the code associated with the task you performed. You can then include this piece of code in your procedure, duplicate the task, and change parameters. That means, if you understand the basics of algorithmics, for loops, if statements, declaration of global and local variables, the syntax to read or write cell values in any sheet of workbook, you can quickly start to build tools to automate any task, perform calculation or extract data from an infinite number of sheets. What happened then? I became Mr. Automation in all internship I did after. The following internship was in the training center of a major French bank. I used VBA to build a tool that estimates travel expenses using a pathfinding algorithm implemented with VBA. It helped the company saving 100,000 euros. Later, I was in charge of the production cost analysis for a major aircraft engine manufacturer. I used VBA to automate the manual data entry tasks for the update of a database, but also the computation of production cost of 1,000 parts. However, nothing is perfect. I also found some limits using VBA when I started to work in logistic operations. First, big data. VBA is very slow. When I started to work with large datasets extracted from warehouse management systems, I faced issues due to the processing time or had Excel files crashing. Second is connectivity. I was struggling to connect my VBA scripts to external APIs like Google Maps or social networks. Third, automation. For a specific project, I needed to automate tasks on the browser. One of our customers was not able to pull data outside their web-based systems. So I needed a tool to automate the extraction, to avoid manually clicking 100 times to get the data I needed. I did not find any method to do that with VBA. Fourth, advanced analytics. When I started to consider using statistical methods, supervised machine learning, for Lean Six Sigma, forecasting, or advanced data analysis, I saw the limits of Excel. So because every time I was looking for solutions for this problem, the first answer I found was using Python, I decided to learn it using it. Like VBA, I started learning by doing. My first project was the automation of item information extraction from an e-commerce platform. To give you the context, it was for a project with a furniture retailer who wanted to open warehouses for the e-commerce platform. To design the warehouse layouts, I needed the product package dimension. However, the customer only provided 60% of the data. When I asked about the missing data, they told me that I can find them on the website. Could you imagine manually scrolling thousands of web pages to copy-paste information like package size or weight? This is why I learned web scrapping using Python. At that time, I was using Selenium. It is a web browser automation tool used to test websites. It can be also used, even if it's not the best solution, to automatically extract data from web pages. I saved several hours of manual work and avoided potential mistakes. This started my learning journey. As soon as I faced an issue, I was trying to figure out a solution using Python. For another project, I used it to optimize the routing for store deliveries. To connect to Baidu API, which is the equivalent of Chinese Google, for geocoding and route timing, but also to generate nice visualization to analyze the deliveries and optimize the routes for cost reduction. With Python, I got access to a rich collection of libraries that improved my productivity and capacity to solve operational issues. For data analytics, I can now connect to any system to extract and process large datasets. I get the capacity to implement advanced mathematical models for prediction, root cause analysis, or decision making. And I can design automation tools using bots for web scrapping, geocoding, data visualization that can be implemented on the cloud. With Python, you have easy access to libraries with detailed documentation to answer any of your operational issues. But nothing is perfect. There are some limits using Python. First limitation is working with unstructured and dirty Excel files. On a daily basis, you don't start your projects with clean, harmonized data. People work with Excel. They don't care about the format. They don't care if the format is not easily readable by your script or about the consistency between one file to another. Your nightmares are merged cells, inconsistent data format, broken links, pivot table, or information stored in cell formatting like color, because they will impact the readability by Pandas library. So the first step for any project will be data cleaning. One of your best allies can be VBA. If you need to deal with Excel data format cleaning, remove merge cells, automating pivot tables, or read data from charts, manage visual formats like color coding, or also manipulate spreadsheets and create formula inside spreadsheet. Python will help you after you get the data in the data frame format, which means first line is a column and the data in rows. It can be also easier to use VBA for automation tasks with some softwares. My first ERP project was working with SAP. SAP GUI is a tool for SAP task automation using Visual Basic. You record the task like VBA, and then you can extract the code that you can adapt later. So it's logic to put it in an Excel VBA script to extract or input data from a file. It was also easier to use Excel VBA when I wanted to automatically create email backups. When you work with Office package softwares, it is the easiest solution. You can find documentations and dedicated modules and functions for most of the tasks that you want to automate. In these cases, you can find Python API, not always official, to do the job, but it makes the job harder most of the time. And finally, in the supply chain world, people use Excel. Python is not that common yet. First issue, people may not trust your tools if it's developed with Python. It can be seen as a black box, and the result will be always questioned. If they have suspicions of some results, people will start to blame the Python black box. Second issue, if you want to share your Python tool, you may face issues with IT department safety rules. That happened to me when I developed a tool for Excel processing with Python. I exported a script using an executable file, EXE, so my colleagues can use it. My file was blocked because of security concerns. I had to do another version using VBA to be able to share it. To conclude, why would you need both? You need VBA because Excel is widely used and more convenient for tools that need to be shared, but also to manage Excel files with format issues or inconsistency that require deep cleaning. You need Python because most of your analysis will involve large datasets, and you need a language faster than VBA. But also, it provides many libraries for task automation, advanced analytics, API and connections with external sources of data. If you want to practice your skills, have a look at my blog, where you'll find case studies with source code and dummy data. For any question, feel free to leave a comment.